Okay, have you ever thought about if there was a difference between the term power versus exponent? And let me give you an example first. Suppose I write this down. How would you say it? Well, one way to say it is 2 to the 5th power. Well, of course, you can also say 2 to the power of 5. Same thing. And here, we are using the word power. But we can also say this as 2 with an exponent of 5. Although this right here is less common, but we can also use the term exponent. So, what's the big deal? That why do we have the word power versus exponent? Just like radical versus root, but that will be for another discussion. To answer this though, in my opinion, I'll first tell you, if we're just doing computation like this with numbers, then it doesn't matter how you say it. You can use the word power or exponent, nobody will get mad at you. But if we're doing some algebra, if we're doing some functions, then there is a difference. And let me write this down right here for you guys. There is a difference between the term power function versus the term exponential function. And the word exponential comes from exponent. So what's the big deal? Here, a power function is in the form of f of x equals some coefficient, let's write it as k. And the key right here is that we are multiplying this with x. And the x is in the base. So the base will be changing. And then we have x to some power p. P is, you know, given. You preset that first. As opposed to exponential functions, we will have the form f of x is equal to some coefficient, that's coe a. But here, we multiply by some base b, and you preset this. Now, the exponent is x. So, this is how a power function looks like, and this is how an exponential function looks like. It depends on where the x is. And of course, they are very different. And once you get to calculus, you will see that for this kind of function, you have the power rule for taking the derivative. And for the exponential function, you will also have to know the derivative for this. And the formulas are very different. And in fact, I can tell you guys a few things more. K and P can be anything here, but here, A can be anything, or except for 0, otherwise it's too boring. But B, there's a condition for that. Well, there are two conditions. We want to make sure that B is positive, because otherwise, let's say if you have negative 1, x can be anything. That's a domain for an exponential function. But if B is less than 0, let's say negative 1 raised to some fractional power like 1/2, this will give us square root of negative 1, which will be the imaginary number I. And if you are talking about functions in the real world, we don't want this to happen. So that's why we want b to be greater than 0. And we also don't want b to be 1, because otherwise 1 to the x power is just always 1. That's a constant function. And now let me just show you guys some examples for this. Right here, let's talk about the most famous example. Let's say we have f of x equals x to the second power. This is a power function, but because the power is 2, so we also know this as a quadratic. The graph of this is a parabola, like this. But now, if we switch the 2 and x, and we get an exponential function, f of x equals 2 to the x, then in this case, the graph of it, it looks like this. Like that. So I think this is how I like to explain that we have the term power versus the term exponent. One thing that I still don't know is, why do we have the term radical versus root? If you know, please let me know. But for now, that's it.